48 model.
Oh, sheriff. So let's go back. Your father was a policeman. Yeah. He was bouncing all around the country.
Bouncing around.
And then finally he went where?
Finally we landed in Fiji.
Yeah.
I can give you the other Snowport, Bergersdorp, and then from Bergersdorp we went to.
But you say he was a policeman, but he was a different kind of policeman. He was like a hard worker.
He was a hard worker for himself. Mm. Yeah, because before he was a policeman, he used to make bricks for people to build up. Then he got this job as a policeman. Because even there, they didn't want him to go and dig sand near the river. So that spoiled his job. Because the other gentleman couldn't get the sand to make this bridge. Yeah. He got this job as a policeman and didn't stay, stayed for 1936.
So he became a policeman in 1936?
No. Mm. Yeah, he became a policeman in 1936. Mm. Yeah. And then he was changed to Middleburg.
And then Middleburg is where you were born.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. Then 1939, I was changed to Newport. In 1939, 1940, 45, after the World War, was changed to Bergersdorp. It was in 1946. 1948, was changed to P. Mm-hmm.
That's where
we decided we're going nowhere. If he goes, he'll just go all by himself and then come back.
So the family decided that?
Yeah.
How many people were in the family? The wife?
We didn't have wives. We were still young then.
But so is your mother?
No, my father and my mother, I don't even know my mother that much. Got separated before I was even 5 years. So I don't even know how they separated. He was still around. So we were staying with the granny.
Yeah, but who was it, you?
It was my elder brother and the other elder brother, which had come here. And then myself, my younger brother. And we were about 13.
13?
13. So including granny.
So you don't lost count at five. What happened with that?
It's still around. Four brothers passed away. I'm the only one too, because the others were my father's sister, cousins. I would call them cousins, sisters. But they grew up here, and we took them as our brothers and sisters, because they didn't know their fathers. Because my father's sister just always came and dump a kid and gone and then come back and dump another kid.
That's like my mother. She's like a Rolling Stone. Yeah, my mother's the same thing. It's like seven kids and six different fathers
They were
twins.
More than we were from my father, because they were almost about six. She had about six kids, and we were four brothers, because the other one, the fifth brother, was staying with my mother.
Yeah. So now what happened to PE? You were in PE? So you settled in PE, that's when you did school?
Schooling, and I did my primary, and then went to high school, Newell High School. But it was so difficult for my daddy, because he was the only working person at home. We all depended on him.
And he was working as a policeman?
As a policeman.
But you mentioned that, he got a car or something like that. He bought an automobile.
He bought a car.
He was supporting like 13, 14 people.
I still wonder how he did it then. How he did it to go and buy a car. And a beautiful car, and it was in good condition. As I say, that Englisher, Dr. McDonald, bought a 48 model in 1948. Mm-hmm. He didn't like now this one. He always came at first, this one, the 1936 one, mm-hmm. from my daddy. But I think he was doing something so that he shouldn't be noticed with this old model. You get what I mean?
Yeah, status. I know, live up but to his doctor.
I think he was doing those ways of himself for himself. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Then I couldn't go further because my daddy didn't have enough money. We were going barefooted in the high school, barefooted, with a 1911. Then it was pounds and pennies. That trouser of mine cost at 1911. It was called 1911. Mm. The cheapest trouser you could get. Once it's been washed, it's going over and over until it's a shorty. But it's been a long bet.
Now they, did they have rands back then? Was it in rands? How much it cost?
No, they didn't have rands. It was pounds and pennies. Oh, it was pounds and pennies then. So we couldn't go further. All of us. They had my elder brothers had to leave to go and work to help him out now. Until my elder brother got married. The other ones was a drunkie. He was a donkey, good mechanic anyway, because he could take that engine and put it there, start it right there and put it back. And then my father bought a truck and we sold wood. I was driving it to go and fetch wood. And
you were driving? Yeah. How old were you then?
No, I was not old.
Oh, how old?
In the 50s. I was a man already.
Okay, now let me go back. So was your father a good mechanic too? Or?
No, he was a mechanic. Kenny doing his own, his own cars and his trucks and all that.
Okay. So now
and
you got
my elder brother, the one I'm after, was also a good mechanic.
So yeah, okay. But wait a second, you're also a mechanic.
Not that much. I don't know. It's my younger brother that passed away last year. He was good in mechanics. He even went to school for. He was trained by a certain company which he was working for. So, they sent him to, what do we call this, to go and get some more experience.
So you were like your daddy mechanic, you know, you could fix what you can fix, and you didn't care about anything else. I'm putting those words in my mouth, I'm sorry, I didn't mean it like that. I mean, you know. So
one guy who always watch what a person does and say, why can't I do it? I believe in that, you see. That's why I could do these things. I said, if you can do that, why can't I do it? Let me try it. And
that's how you made these doors and stuff like that.
Yeah, I did it myself.
Your furniture.
Because I picked this standard bank. Mm-hmm. My wife picked up this two pieces, this. Mm-hmm. And this one is also two pieces. Mm-hmm. My wife picked up those blanks and he brought them in there. And I said, nothing to do. Let me see if I can do something. And I did this.
Mm. Well, talk about yourself. When did you meet your wife? Come on, tell me about this romance. You have to give me the details.
This was the second wife. Oh. I had the first romance in PE. A Miss PE.
What do you mean, Miss PE? She was a beauty queen.
A beauty queen.
Wait a second. So you the tall, dark, and handsome young man. Who got shorts coming all the way up there? How did
and
you get
to
be?
She came to me. Not that I got to her. No, she came to me. And she said that the first time in my life I've seen a guy that I feel for. Mm. And we got started there.
Mm. And was this before?
We got married.
Well, this is during the party, but this is before. The heavy struggle? What time period was this? Was you in jail yet? Let me put it that way.
Well, I didn't. I was never kept in jail for it. It was just jail for 2 weeks. And then they send us out again and then back again. Just like that. Not that I stayed for years in jail, no. Mm-hmm.
It was just the times of apartheid.
They just take you and keep you there for fuckers. Mm. Asking you questions and all that.
To get you on record.
They should have these things on record.
But I mean, just to keep you in the system, what they call the system, You know, so in the United States, they what they do with the young men now, for any charge, they pick you up so they can put you in the system somehow.
They didn't have those systems and all that. Well, they had them, but it was just writing what you're saying, what they're asking you. That's all.
snitch on your friends and all that.
That's all, yeah.
Okay, so let's go back. So now you're with your first wife. You have some children.
No, I didn't have any children with my first wife.
Okay, well look, you know I know you got to go visit the hospital. You got the little thing in the chest or whatever.
No, that's past. I don't even think about it because he messed around too. Mm. She was a donkey. I became a window dresser for Edgar's, yeah. Before Edgar's, it was Top Center. It doesn't any belong. So they opened up almost the whole of the Eastern Cape. So I had to do all those shops, window dressing those shops, and came back say after a month. Cogstad, Peter Maritzburg, Queenstown, which is another one, could be quite a lot.
Yeah, so it's almost like you learned your design and all that stuff from that kind of background. When you design your
creations.
But I mean, like how you put things together,
That's it.
Mm-hmm. So how long?
They gave me a training in Johannesburg, but it wasn't long. 2 months and I came back and I think, you know, it's a gift. Mm-hmm. Because they said, no, we don't see training you. You're too much, too good for this damn thing. Mm-hmm. Except those guys, girls, who stood outside the wire. You know, the poppies, ladies. Mm-hmm. There was, what do we call them? Oh, there were no poppies in the first
mm-hmm. Statue.
There were statues in the windows.
Oh, yeah.
I've got to dress them.
Oh, yeah, the mannequins. We call them the dummies.
The dummies. That's right, the dummies. I want that thing, the dummies. Now, there's this lady dummies. Mm-hmm. One day, I knocked at the window and said,
they want you to pull the lady dummy skirt up. Oh, man.
He said, scream. I had to put curtains now in the windows when I'm busy so that I take them off when I'm finished.
Yeah. So how long did that career last? So
it lasted for quite a long for a time because I was with Top Center, and then other guys came from Edgar's. They offered me more money and a car.
And a car
for going around.
What kind of car was it?
It was a Volkswagen Beetle. The first one was burnt out. I was from Queenstown to between Queenstown and it was a factory fault anyway. It was completely burnt out. It was a factory fault.
Yeah. So what happened next? You went from the for being
Before I was a window dresser, they took me from Stellenbosch. I was a truck driver, delivering big trucks with them, delivering beers and wines. Mm. So I got this job as a window dresser after that. And after that, came a Mr. He was Olena, Mr. Ox. He became an area manager, checking all these shops and all that. He was new in the company.
And did he know the Eastern Cape?
No, he didn't know the Eastern Cape. He was new because he came from Holland.
Holland? Oh.
Yeah, he came from Holland. And then he asked me, he understands that all these shops don't make their targets. What could be the cause of it? I said to him, well, what I can see is the majority says ladies is whites and colors. The only black person is the messenger boy. You know a messenger boy?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, that's the only black person there. Otherwise, all the says ladies are whites and colors. And when they get in, say a customer comes in, a black customer comes in because it's a black man.
Society.
Shops, man, over sales, house in Orlando. Oh. What does it black?
Black area?
Not black area. We call them black. Because they most of the customers are black people. Black people. Yeah. Yeah. When a black person comes in, they want to know, what do you want?
Oh.
What do you want? They follow him as if he's coming to steal something. I must tell this guy I'm in a meeting. This is a dragon swear enough. As a Mupindo, boy, that God and not Goban says I've got a spell, Kitang home someone, go by the husband of Buyan in a spell. Where was I now? They'll call and say, what do you want? So most of the people don't like it as if they come to steal and if he's come to buy. The managers are also rude to the customers. Why was one was a lady in Udine? He was also a Hollander, but yeah, telling you that woman was rude. Toilets are there's two toilets in the building. One is used by the manager, and the other one by says ladies, we can't use those toilets. You understand what I mean?
Yep, yep.
There's these public toilets outside, and you pay on those public toilets before you get in there. You must have about 5 cents, penny then. Mm-hmm. And he was writing all this. And then we were caught because the head office was in Cape Town. So he called me and said, we wanted to know what for. He said, I don't know, we are just being called to come over. He said, you can go, you're the area manager, I'm not the area manager. I'm the, no, man, please, they want you. Now I told you everything, so what wanted there? It was my first time to go into a boardroom. You know a boardroom?
Yeah, yeah.
It was my first time to see a boardroom.
A lot of white guys sitting around.
Well, there are white guys only getting there.
No women?
Women are there also by the managers and all that, but no black person goes to the boardroom. I was the first black person to go into that bedroom. And three white guys. And the chairperson said, okay, let me just finish up these guys first so that I can listen carefully and properly from you people. I finished up with them. And they said, I want to hear your stories then. Mr. Hall said that. Vernon knows about everything because I'm new. All of these stores, all of them.
All of the Eastern Cape?
All of the Eastern Cape stores. The worst people, man, she was. It was an old man, Mr. in Queenstown, with his wife. He's not supposed to, they are not supposed to hire family members, but he was with his wife. And then this lady in Utenay. So rude to black people, I'm telling you. Then another good Dinky and George. A nice way Dinky was in Mtata, and a nice woman, Mr. Cohen, Mrs. Cohen, here in, there were two shops here in Queen and King. The other one, this one, Mr. Mrs. Cohen. And she was a nice lady, and she was quite, you know, helpful to people.
Did those stores do better than the other stores?
No, they were not doing better because the
shop people were still.
Yeah, because the sales ladies are still whites and colors. There was a Mrs. Knight on the other store. The minute you get into the door, you always stand by the door, thinking that that person is coming to steal you. And the day we came with Mr. Ox, he was standing there. He asked me, what do you want?
So they didn't know who Mr. Ox was?
The day Mr. Ox was.
But she didn't know who Mr. Ox was.
She didn't know who Mr. Ox was.
Was her boss.
And I said, they were. She was standing here with me. I said, they were. They were. What do I want? And that's right. Everything. Okay. And then everything came back. Yeah, we left here on a Saturday morning by plane. Got there, we're taken to hey, whites are really, really enjoying it. There's a bar, there's a kitchen. If you want to start at the kitchen, have something to eat, and then go to the bar and help yourself. It's up to you. But it's only for whites. And the money they're getting from the blacks. Right. So
what year was this about?
Was it the 60s? It was 69.
Okay.
Somewhere there, yeah. I left in 1978, when I left the window dressing. Because of a white woman who didn't like me.
This is how they
Then we came back.
What happened with that? What happened? Did they make any changes? Did they make more money?
That's where I'm going to. There was this, before you were hired, you go to the Labor Bureau in London. Offices where you was. You go to the Labor Bureau in London. So we came back. On a Monday, he said, go to the Labor Bureau, get me five ladies there. Black persons. Started in Newton. I was the main laughing person. Yes, the ladies. I think that woman got the yes. They won, yes, the ladies. Now, goodbye. Went back, got into my car. He's got his own car, Mr. Ox. He's got his own car, I've got my own car. And I said, I'm off to Raffinet. What time do you think you'll be there so that I can be ready with the ladies? He said, I'll be there at such a time. Don't get the ladies. Got the ladies? I wasn't doing my job now. I was
he's a pimp. That's what he was. To say what you don't lie, you'll get these ladies. You dropping them off. And they were doing a job for the company.
Take them in their room. Take them in the room and say, you're getting a job here. And this job, you must nurse it like hell. Because if a customer goes in there, ask him nicely, can I help you? Whatever. Don't know. But be nice to customers. Thank you. And they did just that. I'm telling you, all these stores, they made their targets.
Really?
They made their targets heavily. It was worse with Queenstown, because Queenstown, the miners from Johannesburg, He come there and straight from the station into the store. Those miners are from Transkei and this area. They get there. First shop they see is this one. And he gets there somewhere and says, I want this old and I could. Jewish. That's good. Putting trousers and a shirt together. And that's, she said, I want this whole setup. Buy the cash. So they made their targets.
Did the company ever give you any thanks?
Yes, they called me again. Came down.
Because you can't, so you go to the kitchen and the bar.
I didn't have ties and all that. I was given a suit and a tie. A green suit, a nice green suit. And actually, it was specially made for me because I was called to, what's this place? It's making suits special, factory. And they made it for me, and a blue one. But they gave me that and a check of about 500 grand.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Wow.
Thanking me that, wow. You know your job.
Mr. Arti, we're gonna end it there because, believe it or not, you've got to go to the doctor, and we're not going to stop you from going to the doctor. I know you don't want to go, but you got to go, so that's it. Thank you so very much.
You're starting now. I'm giving me a heart attack.
Masixole, cut this off now.